Hello friends, I am Dr. Amit Pradhan, working as an assistant professor in mechanical department of DIT group of institutions Bhopal. I am presenting a short presentation on a topic of design for X. X is a parameter in which we will include the number of fields of design, like of design for manufacturing, design for production, design for assembly, design for recycling, design for life cycle, last one is design for prototyping. The main thing is that how can we include design in number of fields. First of all, we will discuss on DFM, it's a design for manufacturing. The number of gathering information required for this, first one is sketches, drawings, product specifications and design alternatives. Second one is a detailed understanding of production and assembly processes. Next one is estimate of manufacturing costs, production volumes and ramp up timing. Now we will discuss on methods which is included in DIY. It's a procedure. In this slide, you are saying that thing, the proposed design, next one is estimate the manufacturing cost, estimate the manufacturing cost, cost is included by reduce the cost of components, reduce the cost of assembly, reduce the cost of supporting productions. After that, it will proceed by consider the impact of DFM decisions on other factors, then recompute the manufacturing cost, then it is good, then it is acceptable, otherwise it will be transferred to first one. Now it's a DFM method. Estimate the manufacturing cost, reduce the cost of components, reduce the cost of assembly, reduce the cost of supporting production, consider the impact of DFM decision on other factors. Design for manufacturing is a very important parameters for manufacturing units. With the help of design, we can work on the different parameters of manufacturing in the part of cost, components or after that assembly. Next one is, we need to work on estimate the manufacturing cost. How can we estimate the cost which will required for any kind of manufacturing of a product? Number of things or informations are required to estimate these parameters, such like that equipments, informations, toolings, raw materials, labor cost, purchase components, energy, supply, services and waste, which will consider as a scrap after the manufacturing of a product. If the manufacturing cost is our budget, then it will be acceptable and it will be converted in finished goods. After that, we will work on manufacturing cost defined. Basically, number of things are included in this thing, such that sum of all the expenditures for the inputs of the system, that is purchased components, energy, raw materials, etc., and for disposal of the waste produced by the system. Now the manufacturing cost of a product. Manufacturing cost includes with number of parameters such as components, assembly, overhead. Components included with standard and custom, and custom further processing in raw materials, processing and tooling. After that, assembly cost is included with labor cost and equipment and tooling cost. Labor cost is very high for any kind of manufacturing processes. It is undefined parameter. After that, overhead cost, it is supports or indirect allocations. Now the manufacturing cost of a product. Manufacturing cost of a product should be defined or estimated by the designer, or it is beneficial for the organizations. If a manufacturing unit has a proper manufacturing cost estimation of a product, he can estimate it for that. It is included with component cost, that is parts of the product. Product will be manufactured by the combination of a number of parts. It will be assembled by the assembly. Now, the part purchased from the supplier, custom parts made in the manufacturer's own plant or by suppliers according to the manufacturer's design specifications. Next one is assembly cost. Assembly cost included with labor cost, equipment cost and tooling cost. Next one is overhead cost. These are the all other cost just like that. Support cost, that is material handling, quality assurance, purchasing, shipping, receiving facilities, etc. Now the indirect allocations, it is not directly linked to a particular product but must be paid for to be in business. It is a undefined cost. Now the fixed cost versus variable cost. Fixed cost is a cost incurred in predetermined amount regardless of a number of units produced, that is setting up the factory work area or cost of an injection mold. It means fixed cost is a defined cost. Now the variable cost, it is incurred in direct proportion to the number of units produced, that is cost of raw materials. The cost of raw materials will be increased, will be time to time. After the operation or during the operation, the cost of raw material will be very good. Now the reduce the cost of components. How can we reduce the cost of components? It's a basic parameter or needed thing for any kind of design. First of all, understand the process, constraints and cost drivers. Second one, redesign components to eliminate processing steps. Next one is choose the appropriate economic scale for the part process. Next, standardize components and processes. Adhere to black box component procurement. The basic need in any kind of manufacturing, we need to reduce the cost of components by the help of high level of technology, by the high level of design, by the high level of informations or parameters which are included in this design. Now, the understand the processes, constraints and cost drivers. Again, redesign costly parts with the same performance while avoiding high manufacturing cost. High manufacturing cost is a very worst thing for any kind of manufacturing processes, and it is avoidable. For avoid high manufacturing cost, we need to redesign costly parts. The work closely with design engineers raise awareness of difficult operations and high cost. We need to work on these operations which include high level of cost. Redesign components to eliminate processing steps. Reduce the number of steps of the production processes will usually result in reduced cost. To reduce cost, if we are using number of steps to convert a product in a finished one, we need to reduce the steps. Eliminating unnecessary steps, use substitution steps where applicable. Analysis tool, process flowchart and value stream mapping. Choose the appropriate economic scale for the part process. Economics economies of scale. As production volume increases, manufacturing cost usually decrease. If we are work on a mass production, our manufacturing cost usually decrease. Fixed cost divided among more units, just like of labor cost, material cost. Variable costs are lower since the firm can use more efficient processes and equipments. If we are using high level of technology and high level of equipment which are need for that kind of manufacturing, these are related to variable cost, and the cost of equipment will be different at time to time. Economies of scale, the unit cost of a component decreases as the production volume increases. As we know that if we are working on a mass production work, after the mass production of any kind of equipment or product, our unit cost will be decrease. We need to work on economic scale if we want to success a design. For any kind of implementation of a design, we need to work on a scale at what level we are using this technique. Standard components common to more than one product. Analysis tool, group technology, and mass customization. Adhere to black box component procurement. Black box only give a description of what the component has to do, not how to achieve it. The black box defines only one thing, the work of component only. It's not defined how it will work. That's why we need to work on the component or its working principle. Successful black box design requires clear definitions of the functions, interfaces, and interactions of each component. For successful of this event or success of this event, we need to define the functions or interconnections of each component which are used in this product. Reduce the cost of assembly. Assembly is a very important part of a manufacturing. After the assembly, the product will be converted in the finished product. That's why we need to work on it or design a procedure for assembly. Design for assembly index, integrated parts, advantages and disadvantages, maximize ease of assembly, consider customer assembly. Now the DFA system. Butwar Dioha DFM, Monroe and Association, Design, Prohit, Profit, others. Design for assembly index, how can we identify? The basic formula of this DFA index is equal to theoretical minimum number of parts. It will be multiplied in 3 seconds divided by estimated total assembly time. The total assembly time means what's the time which are using or consuming for assembled the product. Determining the theoretical minimum number of parts. Does the part need to move relative to the rest of the assembly? Must the part be made of a different material from the rest of the assembly for fundamental physical reasons? Does the part have to be separated from the assembly for assembly axis replacement or repair? We need to work on theoretical concept or a practical concept. Advantages of integrated part. Do not have to be assembled, often less expensive to fabricate rather than the sum of each individual part. Allows critical geometric features to be controlled by the part fabrication process versus a similar assembly process. The main thing is that if we are using a simple assembly of a simple part, it's a very easy thing. But We are working on a critical geometric systems or critical geometric product which have number of different parts. Then we need to work on critical geometric features. Disadvantages of integrated parts conflict with other sound approaches to minimize cost, not always a wise strategy. Minimize ease of assembly. Part is inserted from the top of the assembly. Part is self-aligning. Part does not need to be oriented. Part requires only one hand for assembly. Part requires no tools. Part is assembled in a single linear motion. Part is secured immediately upon insertion. Now in the assembly, we need to work on the time. That's why we make a assembly within a during a less of time. That's why we need to work on the part of a product which will be assembled in a single or linear motion. Consider customer assembly. Customers will tolerate some assemblies. Design product so that customers can easily and assemble correctly. Customers will likely ignore directions. Reduce the cost of supporting production. Minimize systematic complexity. Inputs, outputs and transforming process. Use smart design decision. Error proofing. Anticipating possible failure modes. Take appropriate corrective action in the early stages. Use color coding to easily identify similar looking but different parts. Consider the impact of DFM decision on other factors. First one is development time, development cost, product quality, external factors. In external factors, two points are there. First one is component reuse. Second one, life cycle cost. Now we will discuss on design for production. The basic part of design for production is design organization, timing of production, material identification, specific design details. These are outputs. Now the production input. In this thing, at various design stages, first one concept, that is production input, functional, transition, tactics, work instruction, production preparation. New ideas provide production input. First one is improper level of detail at proper stage, improper form, just in time. Problem with old approaches. Work is carried out from beginning to end at each stage too slow, needs continuous recycling. Design for production general principles are, first one, use common sense, plan and define. Consider available facilities, consider available tools, consider available worker skills, employ simplicity. Next one is standardize. Now the design for production guideline. There are a number of guidelines for smooth production work. First one is minimize total number of parts, develop a modular design, minimize part variations, design parts to be multifunctional, design part for multi-use, design part for ease of fabrication, avoid separate fasteners. Now the next one is minimize assembly direction, top-down direction preferred, maximize compliances in assembly, minimize handling in assembly, minimize complexity of design, maximize common jigs and fixtures, optimize work position, ease access. Now the types of prototypes. Two dimensions are available for prototypes. First one is physical versus analytical. Second one is comprehensive versus focused. The physical one is tangible artifacts created to approximate the product used for testing and experimentation. Next one is analytical. represents the product in a non-tangible, usually mathematical manner. Next one is product is analyzed, not built. Now, comprehensive versus focused. Comprehensive one is implement all of the attributes of the product, full scale, fully operational version of the product. Now, the focused is implement a few of the attributes of the product, use two or more focused prototypes together to investigate the overall performance of a product. Now, what's the use of a prototype? First one is learning. Will it work? Next one is how well does it meet the customer needs? Communication within the company, with customers, vendors and suppliers. Integration is subsystems and components work together. Then milestone, product achieved a desired level of functionality. Now principle of prototyping. First one is analytical prototypes are generally more flexible than physical prototype. Next one is physical proper prototype are required to detect unanticipated phenomena. A prototype may reduce the risk of costly iterations. A prototype may expedite other development steps. A prototype may restructure task dependencies. Now the use of comprehensive prototypes. It's a graph which is showing the technical or market risk and the cost of comprehensive prototype, time or money. Now the prototyping technology. Today we are using 3D computer modeling. It's a very new technology. First one is easily visualize the 3D form of design, automatically compute physical properties, other more focused descriptions can be created based on the one design, detect geometric interference among parts. Next one is free form fabrication, that is rapid prototyping. In this, 3D printers that create physical objects directly from 3D computer models. It's a less expensive, reduce product development time, improve resulting product. Now the planning for prototypes. Point one is define the purpose of prototype, establish the level of approximation of the prototype, outline an experimental plan, create a schedule for procurement, construction and test. Now the define the purpose, list specific learning and communication goals, list any integration needs, determine if the prototype is intended to be one of the major milestones of the overall product development project. Establish the level of approximation. First one is determine physical or analytical prototype. Second one is choose the simplest prototype that will serve the purpose established in step one. Consider existing prototypes or another prototype being built that can be borrowed. Outline an experimental plan. Use prototype for experimentation. Extract the maximum value from the prototyping activity. Identify the variables of the experiment, test protocol, plan for analyzing and resulting data. Create a schedule for procurement, construction and test. This is determine when parts are ready to be assembled, determine the date when prototype will be first tested, determine expectation for completed testing and final results. Milestone prototypes. Alpha prototype is first one. In this, assess whether the product work is intended. Second one is beta prototype. Assess reliability and to identify any bugs in the product. Now, pre-production prototype. It's the first products produced by the entire production process. Okay, thank you. In this topic, the X is a variable in which we can consider any kind of topics related to design or anything. Okay, thank you.